Everyone, welcome to our channel Current Affairs for you. Let's begin the important current affairs of 8th January for 2021. Watch the video completely, share with your friends and subscribe the channel. So the first question for today is Claire Poloczak said to become first female match official in men's test match. She belongs to which country? Options are UK, Indonesia, Australia, Romania. So Claire Poloczak, she belongs to Australia and she has become first female match official in a men's test match during the match between India and Australia. Third test match between India and versus Australia. Now, UK, United Kingdom in recent news, Boris Johnson, the Prime Minister of UK, has been invited as chief guest for 26th January, which is Republic Day of India. Next, Indonesia, there is a mountain called Mount Eli Levatolok volcano has been erupted. Next, Romania. So Florin Situ has been appointed as new prime minister for Romania. So let's talk about Claire Poloczak. Claire Poloczak became first female match official in men's test cricket during the third test between India and Australia, where she acts as fourth umpire. Next question, who wrote the book India's 71-year test journey to triumph in Australia? Options are Sudhamurthy, R. Kaushik, Shivatanu Pillai, Subha Sharma, Anupam Kher. So option B is correct here. R. Kaushik wrote a book called India's 71-year test journey to triumph in Australia. And this book is released by Ravi Shastri. Next. So the Indian coach of Ravi Shastri released this book called 71-year test journey to triumph in Australia. Next, Sudhamurthy wrote Grandparents Bag of Stories. Shivatanu Pillai wrote 40 Years with Abdul Kalam Untold Stories. Subha Sharma wrote Avastis of Amnagari. Anupam Kher wrote Your Best Day is Today. Next, in which of the following city Khelo India Ice Hockey Tournament has begun? Options are Kargil, Ladakh, New Delhi, Pune, Guwahati, Assam, Haryana. So option A is correct here. Kargil, which is in the Union Territory of Ladakh, there Khelo India Ice Hockey Tournament has begun. Now the remaining options are Khelo India Youth Games. The first Khelo India Youth Games were held in New Delhi and the second were held at Pune, third held at Guwahati and the fourth one are going to be held in Panchkula, which is in Haryana. With which of the following country India successfully tested MRSAM? Options Japan, Russia, China, Israel. So option D is correct here. With Israel, India successfully test fired MRSAM. MRSAM stands for medium ranged surface to air missile. So recently Japan is going to make wood based satellite by 2023. Russia recently sent a satellite called Angara 5. And China, Geofen 14. So next, let's talk about this MRSAM. The full form of MRSAM is medium range surface to air missile, and this is developed by DRDO. DRDO stands for Defense Research and Development Organization, headquarters located in New Delhi, and the chairman for DRDO is Satish Reddy. And recently he testified Varunastra, a heavy weight torpedo, and Israel Aerospace Industries. Next question, in which of the following state world's largest floating solar energy project will begin power generation by 2022 to 2023? Options are Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Punjab, Maharashtra. So option A is correct here. Madhya Pradesh state government, which is having world's largest floating solar energy, and it is going to begin power generation by 2022 to 2023. And now Andhra Pradesh in recent news and Punjab in recent news, Maharashtra. Andhra Pradesh in recent news, Navaratnalu Pedalandariki Illu. Navaratnalu Pedalandariki Illu scheme launched by Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh YS Jagan Mohan Reddy. Punjab state government, the Chief Minister of Punjab Captain Amarinder Singh launched Divyangjan Shaktikaran Yojana. Divyangjan Shaktikaran Yojana. So Maharashtra recently news. So Maharashtra state government in partnered with Google introducing digital education in government schools across the state of Maharashtra, and the Chief Minister of Maharashtra is Uddhav Thackeray. So let's talk about this solar energy power project, which is having 600 megawatts and it is on Omkareshwar Dam, which is also important. They will also ask the location and on which river, Narmada River, and in which district, Khandwa district of Madhya Pradesh. Next question, who is the head of committee formed to protect language, culture and land of Ladakh? Options are Narendra Modi, G. Kishan Reddy, Giridhar Aramane, Amit Khare. So option B is correct here. G. Kishan Reddy has been appointed as the head of a committee formed to protect language, culture and land of Ladakh, the union territory, land of Ladakh. Who is the head? G. Kishan Reddy. So Narendra Modi is the head of a committee to celebrate 400th birth anniversary of Guru Nanak. And so Giridhar Aramane has been the head of a committee to build logistic parks in India. Amit Khare is the head of a committee to impart mother tongue in technical education. Technical education, mother tongue. It is Amit Khare is the head of the committee. Next question. Who inaugurated Rewari Madar Freight Corridor? Options are Narendra Modi, Narendra Batra, Sam Dalrymple, Ruskin Bond. So Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi inaugurated Rewari Madar Freight Corridor. So Narendra Batra, he is the head of Federation of Hockey in India, he is the head, and recently he won an award. If you know the award, comment in the comment box. And Sam Dalrymple wrote a book recently, and Ruskin Bond wrote a book recently. What are those books? Let's discuss. So Sam Dalrymple wrote Five Partitions, Making of Modern Asia. Ruskin Bond wrote a book called How to Be a Writer. Next question. So this Rewari and Madar corridor, it's 306 kilometer long. Rewari, which is in Haryana, and Madar, which is in Rajasthan section of WDFC, which stands for Western Dedicated Freight Corridor, which is flagged off by Narendra Modi. And this is the world's first double stack long haul 1.5 kilometer container train. Next question. India provide 30.66 crore NR for reconstruction of earth affected schools in which country? Options are Bangladesh, Australia, Sri Lanka, Nepal. So this is in Nepal. So India is going to give 30.66 crore Nepali rupees for reconstruction of earthquake affected schools in Nepal country. Now recently India and Bangladesh has a naval exercise called Bongo Sagar is a naval exercise between India and Bangladesh. India, USA, Japan, Australia, these four countries had a quadrilateral naval exercise called Malabar. Next, India and Sri Lanka had Slinex. It's also a naval exercise. Next question. Who wrote the book called Right Under Our Nose? Options are G. Krishnan, Vijay Lokpally, R. Giridharan, Jairam Ramesh. So option C is correct here. Giridharan wrote a book called Right Under Our Nose. He is RBI manager and it's his debut book. And G. Krishnan and Vijay Lokpally, these two wrote a book called The Hitman Rohit Sharma Story. And Jairam Ramesh wrote a book called The Light of Asia, The Poem That Defined Buddha. So The Light of Asia, The Poem That Defined Buddha, it is written by Jairam Ramesh. Next question. Last question for today. Who has been appointed as Chief Justice of Andhra Pradesh High Court? Options are Arup Kumar Goswami, Hema Kohli, S. Muralidhar, Pankaj Mittal. So option A is correct here. Arup Kumar Goswami has been appointed as Chief Justice of AP, Andhra Pradesh High Court, and Hima Kohli has been appointed as Telangana State High Chief Justice, and S. Muralidhar has been appointed as Odisha's Chief Justice, and Pankaj Mittal is going to be appointed as Chief Justice for Union Territories of Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh. So that's all for today's current affairs. Hope you guys like the video. Thank you for watching until the end. Share with your friends.